Chonburi, Soo Shat came in at first from Pulangchon Party as expected, won over 30,000 votes. And as for party list MP candidates, the Democrat Party came in at first. Now we're at Nongbolampu province.
Phum Jai Tai came second, beating the Democrat.
Yes, for constituency.
Right.
And now we're going to Ubon Ratchathani for the Northeast constituency. One Khun Water seat came in at first from Pheu Thai Party for both constituency and party list MP candidates, right, followed by Democrats.
And coming to Chaiyaphum with seven MPs in this constituency, the Phum Jai Tai is taking the lead with over 36,000 votes, followed closely by the Pheu Thai and then the Democrat coming in third. But right now we're having a comment
interview, yes,
from
another foreign media. That's right. Khun Yin Som from Cambodia. Good evening.
Good evening, yes.
Thank you for joining us tonight.
No worries.
Okay. Now, have you seen the latest result of the election returns?
Yes, I heard that. there's a former prime minister has insisted,
right,
they have the leading,
yes,
numbers,
right,
in Thailand.
Yes. Now,
what's your
take on that? What's your comment on that?
My comment on that, I think this is probably the good coming result between a good relationship with our two countries, because,
right,
our two countries, in the past have a good relationship in terms of economic,
right,
strengthening and all, etc. I think, this is bringing a good sign for the futures of our country.
Mm-hmm. Now, did it take you by surprise at all, or this is what you expected?
I was following the situation the last couple of days as well. I suspect that if the new government will be selected and form a new government, and then this could be bringing a sign of bringing to a relationship in term of economic, because both countries, on behalf of the South Asian nation, rely on economic from each other.
Right.
That's what I expected, you know.
Mm-hmm. Well, if the Pheu Thai actually formed a new government and became the government, do you think that the Cambodian issue between Thai and Cambodia will become less tightened?
Well, I think if she formed the government, Cambodia and Thai, because I've been followed to her previous election campaign, party campaign, as well. They have a good policy strengthening among the Asian countries, especially Cambodia, because Cambodia was a neighboring country and also be a good friend, be rely on,
right,
a better economic from Thailand as well. So this is one of the good signs to the future relationship among our two countries.
Right. Now, regarding the Pheu Thai victory, what is the implication for your country as a whole? Include and not include the Thai-Cambodian border issue, just as a whole in general?
The whole in general will bring a benefit economic in terms of among our country, because most of the Cambodian relying on the Thai, we would like to use the Thai products, and also,
right,
most of that product were, as well as the I think that we can be well, actually we are the neighbor country. We want to live in peaceful as a nation. We don't want to create any problems among the country in the region, especially the neighboring country. We want to live in a better, like, economic situation and all that as a neighbor country, you know.
And also, apart from being a neighbor country, we're also a fellow ASEAN country as well. What sort of policies do you expect the new government to issue in order to improve?
I expect the coming new government could be issued could achieve better, like we have the Asian five pillars, so we should work on those five pillars, which economic, human rights, democracy. This new government, I hope that will just strengthening more on economic and democracy.
Mm-hmm, right.
Even though Cambodian is not yet 100% sure on the human rights, but this new Thai government, hopefully that can do something to help Cambodia as well, because we are living as a small numbers country in this region.
Mm-hmm. Now, Mr. Yin, what about the foreign policies? What do you hope to see as far as the new government with the foreign policies?
Foreign policy, I hope to see this new government will have a good policy in terms of relationship, like helping each other and have a good tie among other countries to solve the problem, to avoid any conflict in terms of human respect, even though some of those Cambodian workers were working in Thailand.
Mm-hmm.
And also this new government will hope that will have a good policy to help Cambodian, like I said before, not only on human rights democracy, but also strengthening a good relationship. What I mean a good relationship is to strengthening on economy and business grow as well among other countries.
Mm-hmm. Thank you so much, Mr. Yin, for your outlook.
No worry. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Now we have the opinion from the Malaysian's analyst, Dr. Saleh Hassan.
Back to Dr. Saleh Hassan from Malaysia. Doctor, are you on in the line with us?
Yes,
Doctor. What repercussions do you think the Thai general election will have on the international relations among the ASEAN countries?
I think the result of the election is very important for ASEAN. You know? I think we hopefully that the result of the election will bring stability and peace in Thailand.
Yes.
So that the ASEAN as a whole will go forward economically, you know. So I think the result of the election hopefully will, you know, encourage the neighbors to cooperate together, you know, when Thailand can achieve stability and peace, then together the ASEAN countries can be successful, no? I mean, that's
right.
My feeling that.
Right.
Yes.
Right. What type of foreign policies do you expect to see from Thailand?
Again, please?
What type of foreign policies do you want to see from Thailand, from the new government?
Yeah. I think the most important thing is we want to see that the ASEAN members can work together, no? And the problems in ASEAN can be solved. As, for example, problem with Thailand, with Cambodia, no? Mm-hmm. And hopefully the cooperation among ASEAN will be greater, no? In that sense, that we can achieve better prosperity for ASEAN countries, no? And I think we want the situation in Thailand to improve. We want the situation in Thailand to be stable, so that you know the country in ASEAN can live in peace, you know, and we can together work towards peaceful and prosperity among ASEAN.
Okay, thank you very much, Dr. Saleh Hassan, for joining us.
All right.
Thank you very much.
Welcome.
Now, if you look at...
Coming up next, Cambodia's king and France prime minister and the democratic dialogue between the Philippines and Myanmar after the break.